Y'all come on in. We got chairs.
Yeah, we have a few
of them. Not as many as there are butts in the room.
Four more chairs.
Seems sad.
And I'll stand up here in a second, actually. So five chairs.
See, there you go. You're on it.
We have lots of chairs. People sit in them. Mm-hmm. With their butts.
Step out from behind yourself. You have been hiding in your own shadow for far too long. No one has ever had the eyes to see that you are beautiful, or the mouth to be rendered speechless by how stunning you are. Know that now. I want to hear a poem from you. I want to hear a song from you. I want to hear your name called, like dawn's first light on the moon. And with every step you take towards this stage, I want to know you better. Stop hiding. Day in and day out, you are at least a little bit trapped. I know this, because I'm alive. Just like you. This right here, this is your freedom. Trembling, terrified as you might be, there is no reason to be afraid. I just want to hear what it sounds like when you break free. Know that tonight, when I go to bed, I will dream of making love to your words and your songs. You all make me come back to these places, finding more spirituality in a dust art gallery in Canton on a Friday night than a church on a Sunday morning. Your performances are sermons to me. Whatever you said your song was about when you sang it, or your poem was about when you wrote it, it is about truth. Know that, and you will know God on this stage. If you are nervous, if you are shaking, love that. That is your butterflies trying to tell you that you are going to do something beautiful, and you are. Hold tight to this moment. It will change your life if you let it. Then let go. Let this experience overtake you like every erotic moment you've never had. You are badass sexy for signing that open mic list. Wait, is there an open mic list?
No.
Sign the open mic list, and then you are badass sexy for getting up here. Don't disrespect your name by bringing anything less than everything you are and everything you've ever wanted to be, because I have torn my thesaurus apart looking for words to tell you how unique and incredible you are. You inspire me to be everything I want to be as soon as I want to be it. Inspiration? This is Sunday morning to me. This is gospel to me. You are the angel's choir and God's holy light. Holy shit. Get up here. Piece your poems together with pop cans and pipe cleaners and get up here. Stitch your songs together with love notes your heart wrote as a child and get up here. Hidden deep within your heart is the high heroine will never hold. It is the most beautiful afterglow I have ever seen, and it is yours. And when you carry that off stage with you, dare to look my way. Just watch. I'm going to clap you the best love poem I have ever written. So Valentine's Day is right around the corner. So I wrote this, some corner.
It's going to jump out of
three
you
more corners.
So here's a Valentine's Day poem I wrote. Roses are red, violets are blue. I know you like roses, so that's what I bought you. But it turns out the cut flower industry has secrets to hide, drenching its flowers in gallons of pesticide. So there goes one tradition torn to shreds. Next year I'll just buy chocolate instead. So roses were red and chocolate is brown. You ask if it's fair trade. All I can do is frown. It's M&M, Mars, Hershey, or one of those brands. Turned out it was probably made with slave labor hands. Maybe I'm just trying too hard. Next time, I'll get you a nice V-Day card. So roses were red, this envelope is pink. When I see your disappointment, it makes my heart sink. Yeah. This card, it wasn't printed on recycled stock. And now I feel like the world's biggest cock. Next year, fuck presents. Forget all things capitalist. No time like the holidays to be a good activist. No presents, no cards. I'm just gonna say, I love you. Happy made-up bullshit holiday. Woo! Dear Moon, I smiled back at you last night. I hope you saw it. Don't ever let anyone tell you your craters aren't beautiful. Dear Sun, I know I don't always want you around, but that doesn't mean I ever want you to leave. Dear tree, right now you are a tiny sapling in my front yard, but never acknowledge any limit to how big you can grow. Dear God, maybe tomorrow. Thanks for waiting up. Dear Mom, I still haven't forgiven myself for how free I felt after you died. Dear ex-girlfriend, nothing you ever did will ever make you deserve what I did. I will spend the rest of my life knowing that. I hope you will too. Dear Internet, I hate how much time I waste on you, but I love the world that you are capable of showing me. Dear Karate, I know you're not the source of everything good in me, but I never had anything bring it out quite so easily. Dear Life, you are a confused mess. To me, that makes us brothers. Dear Poetry, how about tonight? Thanks for waiting up. Dear Friends, I'm sorry I suck at calling, or writing, or any communicating at all. This is not an indication of the place you hold in my heart. Dear World, sometimes I need to hide. How dare you have so many things that need changing. Dear Love of my life, I wake up every day afraid I don't deserve you. Dear Religion, you are beautiful. Dear people who practice religion, just because your religion is beautiful does not mean you are doing good things with it. Dear Sleep, more please. Dear Cartwheels, more please. Dear Popcorn, more please. Dear Defeat, dear Hopelessness, dear Giving Up. Maybe tomorrow, but don't wait up. Have you ever met your guardian angel? Golden halo shining like a baby's smile. Soft light falling on strong wings covered in white feathers. Hands pressed together, ever in prayer. Eyes always angled upward, ready to receive the righteous instruction. If by chance you have met your angel and they match this description, I would like you to know that though I may be small in stature and unable to match you in a fair fist fight, my guardian angel will kick your guardian angel's holy ass. She's never seen the celestial waiting room, never been in God's routine rotation. A guardian angel like mine is only summoned for special occasions. My friends, I am that special occasion. My guardian angel is a 110-pound punk rock chick with pink hair, black leather wings, Bible verses tattooed on her skin. Her name is Peace. Where keeping me safe is concerned, there are no laws that can't be loosened to suit her need. The police can't even see her because Peace is something that will never be understood by police. Yeah. Yeah, my guardian angel likes to party. Sometimes she likes to smoke a little, not because she needs it to get high, but because it slows her down enough so that maybe in a television tuned to the channel of God, I may come to some momentary understanding of her. I have not made her life easy. When I was 4, I left my apartment and wandered westward to see the world. 3 blocks away, Peace took me by the hand and walked me back to my apartment where my mom was sobbing, terrified that I'd been taken. A week later, I wandered off again. This world is a scary place, and I have never been smart enough to be scared. I have made too many mistakes, hung out with too many drunk family members, and been far too trusting of people who didn't deserve it to still be alive and healthy today. Peace is pale from staying up with me too many nights when I can't sleep, and when I do sleep, Peace is working on her website. Its content is illegal in most states because truth and hope have officially been declared pornographic. They are offensive. They are disgusting. So now, in the truest sense of the word, my guardian angel is a professional lover. If she were a man, the number of souls she's touched would be counted as nothing more than notches on her bedpost. But Peace is more powerful than any man. I sometimes close my eyes and pretend that I am something strong, but for all my big words and bullshit, the only reason I'm still standing here is because I've got a 110-pound punk rock chick standing over me, a lit cigarette in one hand and God's promise in the other. She's tough when I can't be, and even tougher when I'm stupid enough to think I'm strong enough. So if you see her flying through your dreams, don't be afraid. But please, just get out of her way. Chances are I'm in trouble again. She's on her way to rescue me. In a world as dangerous as ours, Peace can never come fast enough. How am I doing on time?
I got about 11 minutes.
11 minutes. Sweet.
Or more if you want.
All crap. I'll just be up here till 9. It's all good. All right. The writing process. Find a notebook. Find the right notebook. Not the short story notebook. It has to be the poetry notebook. Find a pen. Find a working pen. Find a working black pen. Find a working black pen, but with red ink. Stare at the paper. It's slightly off color because it's made from 100% post-consumer waste. Start writing a poem about how your efforts to be creative are environmentally friendly. Stop the poem 2 lines in because you realize you sound like a douchebag. Okay, start over. New game. New game, new plan. New plan, new page. New page, new poem. Write about politics. Fuck politics. Write about love. Fuck love. Write about music or art or God or whatever. Just so much. Back to this piece of paper. Its blue lines taunt you. Its blue lines are laughing at your inability to put anything useful between them. You know what? Fuck the notebook. Get the laptop. You'll write better on it anyways. Open a new Word document. Word crashes. Fuck Microsoft Word. You need inspiration anyway, so go on YouTube, look up poets on YouTube, look up poets who've already written everything you've ever thought about writing and did it better than you did anyways. These amazing poets and their words make you want to write. Look at cat videos. Look at dog videos. Look at dogs chasing cats videos. Rate them. Comment on them. Now you're writing. Employ a plethora of LOLs and Raffles. Look up Raffle on the Wikipedia because you're curious about how long it's been in use. Look up Def Leppard instead. They were an 80s metal hair band. Their drummer only has one arm. You have a Facebook friend who would find that fascinating. Go on Facebook and your productivity is now doomed. There's a post about white male privilege from that one guy you met 4 years ago. He's white and male. Posting on Facebook is how he fights oppression. You think writing a poem about Facebook activism might be a good idea, but right below that is a picture of a dancing panda bear, so you click on that, obviously. Psych! It's an Onion article about Barack Obama. All right, you know what you need? You need some porn. That's right. Go on your favorite site. They have a new girl. She's pretty. She looks like that girl you had a crush on in junior high. Her name was Amanda. She kissed you on the cheek once in the park. You lost touch with her when you two went to different high schools. You've no idea what path her life is on after that, or how she got on your favorite porn site, or why you even feel what you feel about that. But now, somehow, looking at her naked feels wrong. Put away the laptop. Pick up your notebook. Write the poem. Just write the damn poem. Alright, this is a found poem. I can't really take credit for writing this. The problem is I don't think anybody else can either. So we're going to call this poem Lost in Facebook Translation. See no, secluded bully. Sensitive, shaking, nervous, and that you'd make sure the mixture is to be in this job. Ask for miss myself when times are still weak in the world than this. We were the thought of my own identity. That's right. The story was incoherent, like won't linked, but there is something in the intertwined. Outside of using actors, one pair of flip the switch, get different roles in each of the park is like reading the writing style trends that matter. Writer, let stories from press myself to the end of a poem, but not going to be focused on the what. Late reason or any reason continuity words set that gift to be picked up. Tell a story. The meaning of the character found talk. Touch, touch, or just stay close to each other, but never speaking. The poor fairy ficus carnival and trailer which two actors brought attractive and dragging the straight of the character. Good for. Once again, a sunlight lights every character. He responsible, beautifully last sing a solo. Depths, tears, will flow in the state of Haiti, have very prominent moments too. apart from being your crotch. He will make us lose focus often. But I have to admire your light work. It's easy to focus on driving atmosphere, but beautiful as ultrasounds. Selection includes the soundtrack and surrounded by good atmosphere. While me, necessary, and the mind of insignificance trying to talk about the important stories and words of your identity, can we go back to see the importance of the things that happen in front of, at least? It's important to the owner of the words, stories, and his own identity, and maybe important or not. Don't have to question anything, because it is part of my life. We have to embrace it. Me, myself, and the mind of insignificance, open to represent the 31st of July with only this embroidered Moonspace Institute. I understand, that made absolutely no sense. It was a direct Facebook translation of a movie from India, and it was just so poetic that I couldn't change a word of it. Of course, it didn't make any sense. Maybe I should have opened with that. I've never actually performed that one before.
You should.
All right, one more?
Sure.
Long before I knew that L, G, B, or T were anything more than letters of the alphabet, I loved rainbows. Colors and I attracted each other like vivid magnets, and they followed me around like lovesick pets. Red was always close to my heart, but it was safe because it had orange around it to protect it. Blue made its home in my head. Yellow hung out in my hands. Green kept my feet forever moving. And indigo wove its way through me like an almighty life force. Before bed, when other kids were saying prayers they didn't really understand, or maybe telling God what they wanted for Christmas, I was going on adventures through rainbows miles long. I floated through the mist of color, letting each pigment mix with the one before, saturating my soul until it looked like it had been spray-painted by dysfunctional deities. I never did finish these journeys awake. I was always asleep by the time I hit indigo, and past indigo was violet, where my dreams lived. As long as I was in this cradle of consummate color, I was invincible. But somewhere along the way, something convinced me that I needed to outgrow my glow the way leaves outgrow their trees, and I have been falling ever since, floating further away from everything fantastic. God damn it! I used to have superpowers. I used to see amazing things, not just my own colors. I used to see shaded stains on everybody, people walking down the street leaving tinted trails behind them, the whole world so full of pure brilliance. It was an astounding experience, just walking out the front door. I used to mean it when I smiled. I used to love everyone I met. I used to be amazing. There's no orange left around my heart now. I upgraded to this cold gray, built a wall so thick no rainbow will ever reach it, and I keep myself busy, 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 so I never have to think about it. I intentionally overload my schedule, so I'm always running off in every direction, except up. And I know, I am too young to be talking this shit, and we can spend days trying to one-up each other on whose life got the greater share of despair, but if you've forgotten what it's like to be blown back by how amazing you are, this poem is about you too. Your desaturated dreams don't even begin to add up to the degrees of brilliance that you deserve. Take your sword and cut through the beige and gray of every piece of pain that you have ever used to define you. Quit hating other people for robbing you of your rainbows, and blaming yourself for letting them go. Do you remember what it was like to float? Do you remember what it was like to see colors so pure they made you believe in a god? Well, I almost do too. So tonight, instead of praying, I am going on the prowl for prisms. I might tentatively tiptoe into red, but I will dive into orange, and motherfuckers, y'all, you better be there. It's not even a long trip. Bring your blankets and your teddy bears and leave your laptops behind, because tonight we are going to run through rainstorms of radiance straight towards the sun, and if we get separated along the way, that's okay. Don't you ever stop chasing those rainbows. When you get there, I'll be waiting for you. Won't even be hard to recognize me. I'll be the heart full of red blue on my head. I will be waiting for you just past Indigo. I will take your hand, and we can voyage together into Violet, followed by everyone we have ever forgotten how to love. Y'all don't even have to sleep. Just remember how to dream. Thanks, everyone.